Please rise for the singing of our national anthem by WHS Senior Choral Union.
Class of 2022, please be seated. Good afternoon, friends, family, and soon-to-be Westborough High School graduates. We made it. The day has come, and in a few minutes, we will together transition from being Westborough High School students to Westborough High School alumni. My name is Sasha Wilkinson, and over the past 4 years, I've been honored to serve as a student body president. Getting to work with all of you and know each and every one of you during our time, our class has accomplished a lot. But first, I would like to thank a few people who have made this event, all the senior events this week, and all the events we have had over the past 4 years possible. We couldn't have done it without you. I would like to take a moment to thank Mr. Callahan for always being supportive of our events, ideas, and to all of the faculty and staff who have helped create a safe, educational, and fun learning environment here at Westborough High. Your continuous efforts, innovative adaptability with the pandemic, and relentless support has enabled us to make the most of these past 4 years. I would also like to thank all the parents and family members with us tonight. Your constant efforts, whether it be driving to sports practices, clubs, concerts, or helping your child 24/7 during the pandemic, you're the backbone behind every amazing student. I would also personally like to thank my two biggest supporters, Mackie and Minnow, as well as the coolest person I know, Fred, and last but not least, my mom and dad, who made my existence possible. Sorry. Last and most importantly, I wanted to thank the class of 2022 graduates for making these past 4 years so enjoyable. I look around here today and I see a class of leaders, role models, and mentors. I see a class of students who has endured so much and somehow managed to do so gracefully and with constant optimism and enthusiasm. Although we have endured a lot, being faced with the challenges of COVID-19 in the spring of 2020, we have also achieved a lot. As of right now, we are the only grade in Westborough High School to have a single year of complete normalcy, our freshman year. It's hard to believe that the last year without masks, social distancing, COVID testing, and restrictions was nearly 3 years ago. Luckily, this past year, a lot has opened up. With the mask mandates being lifted, easing of social distancing restrictions, and the return of pre-pandemic events. However, with these beginning steps towards normalcy, we need a reminder of what normal is. And our class of 2022 has served as leaders, bringing back sports crowds, spirit days, bringing back school dances, concessions, and class fundraisers. We have revived events such as a variation of our own foreign language week, volleyball tournaments, and seemingly endless StuCo community events. Although this pursuit of the sort of pre-pandemic times is not nearly complete, and there is still so much work left to be done, the participation, patience, and resilience of every single student has begun to not only rebuild the community events we once had, but also expand them even more. Like most things, Westborough is a work in progress, tirelessly working to become the best version of itself. This year, we were able to introduce both serious and necessary events, such as the Unity Week and multiple SEL lessons, as well as purely fun events, such as Bring Your Own Banana Day or student versus basketball versus faculty basketball games. We have exemplified what it means to persevere through hardships and come out the other side stronger and as passionate leaders. Each and every one of us has overcome our own versions of adversity and are better for it. As we enter a world increasingly faced with new challenges and with many more to come in the future, I'm glad to embark on this journey with all of you. I'm proud of how far we've come, and I'm confident that if anyone can help find solutions to the future's world issues, it's all of you. Westborough has given us the skills, resources, and most importantly, one another as tools to use in our future endeavors. So don't forget about all that you have accomplished, where you have been, and who will always be there to support you. Regardless of where we all end up in these coming years, regardless of all the amazing things we do, never forget that you will always be a part of Westborough High School Class of 2022 family. And I hope that the Westborough High School Class of 2022 will always be a part of you.
Hello, class of 2022. My name is Lisa Edinburgh. I am chair of the Westborough School Committee. On behalf of my colleagues who serve on the committee, it is an honor to welcome you to your class of 2022 Westborough High School graduation ceremony. Yay. Welcome, families, friends, Westborough High School teachers, staff, administrators, and community members who are gathered here to celebrate each of you and this important milestone. American cartoonist Bill Keen says, "Yesterday's the past, tomorrow's the future, but today is a gift. That's why it is called the present." Time. Many examine time's passage as it ebbs and flows through our lives, from birth to high school graduation. Time and experiences sink memories into our souls, some that foster wisdom and joy, and others that add sadness and heartache. Whether your memories include sports, playing an instrument, acting in plays, singing, learning what you are passionate about, they vary. Time has shaped you through the pandemic, world events, tragedies, and successes within your personal lives. We have the opportunity to pause right now at your commencement, to ponder the past, imagine a flourishing future, and to be present. Time and its nuances remind me of a Doctor Who episode called Blink. It's definitely a nightmarish episode, containing creepy statues that move toward you when you blink. Doctor Who says, "Don't turn your back, don't look away, and don't blink." I believe the statues are a metaphor for time. Blink and time passes without contemplation, without introspection, without the wisdom that it can carry. Blink and you may miss the opportunities to internalize a particular moment, experience growth and learning, and miss the good times that life has to share. Blink and time wins, dominating you, keeping you captive. Recently, a book of essays by Mary Laura Philpott caught my attention called I Miss You When I Blink. The title refers to her five-year-old son, who recognized when he closed his eyes, he missed his mother. I believe it characterizes time's passage, our relationships, and inner wisdom. I Miss You When I Blink refers to missing 13 years of teachers who guided, taught, and nurtured your curiosity and education. I Miss You When I Blink refers to missing your family, plus possibly grandparents, cousins, family friends, and chosen family. I Miss You When I Blink refers to the close friends you've made and those you may not see regularly in the future. I Miss You When I Blink refers to your younger self, growing into who you have become, identities you've explored. I Miss You When I Blink refers to how quickly time passes, its trajectory too fast to gauge. In the blink of an eye, we can miss or capture a moment. Let's try it. Everyone, blink and see yourself in kindergarten. Blink and see yourself starting high school. Blink and see yourself in 5 years. Blink and see the present moment. Within a blink, we can remember the past. Within a blink, we can dream of the future. And within a blink of our eyes, we can be present. Get ready. 3, 2, 1, blink. You are graduating. Yes, you are. And now, keep your eyes wide open. Pause to recognize your tangible accomplishment. Don't let it pass without acknowledgement. Don't let it pass without a smile. Don't let it pass without feeling pride in yourself and from your parents, teachers, and loved ones. Be proud of the education you've worked hard for and acquired. Embrace the connections and relationships you've established and build the future you dream of creating. And remember to capture the present moments before you blink and miss them. It is my honor to congratulate each and every one of you and your families from the graduating class of 2022 as you enter your next phase of life. And most importantly, don't turn away, don't look away, and don't blink, because we will miss you all when we blink.
Good afternoon. My name is Arashi Pant, and I'm so grateful for the opportunity to speak here today. On the first day of school my freshman year, we were asked to share one fact about ourselves with a neighbor in geometry class. We then would go around the room introducing our neighbors. I've never known what types of things to say during all these awkward icebreakers, so I turned to my friend and, off the top of my head, blurted out that I was a perfectionist. Then, feeling that that comment was super pretentious for a one fact about you statement, I tried to undo it and say that I had gone to Universal Studios over the summer and that it had been really fun, that I'd really enjoyed it, etc. Maybe it was because it was easier to say that when our term came around, my friend said, "This is Arashi, she's a perfectionist." Yay, first impressions. Then Mrs. Magnini looked at me and said, "You know that's not necessarily a good thing, right?" Well, I was embarrassed and I blushed and mumbled a, "Yeah," eager to move on. But I didn't quite understand that it wasn't necessarily a good thing. My thought process was that perfectionism has the word perfect in it, so how could it really be such a bad thing? Thinking back at where I was 4 years ago, I remember that I used to put so much time and effort into a lot of things that didn't really matter. For example, some of my peak eighth grade moments were when I gave a 20-minute Theodore Roosevelt presentation to a very bored class, or when I limboed under Mr. Cooley's desk twice to win bonus points for the whole class, which it turned out that we were never actually given. I don't remember how, but I also have a contract saying that I want a mansion, which Mr. Cooley owes me on the date of my graduation, so. But I digress. Speaking of digressions, one big one that happened to us all was the pandemic, which of course came at the end of our sophomore year. It taught us all many things, mostly how to live in a world straight out of a dystopian novel with an all over the place plot featuring murder hornets, randomly appearing monoliths, and fire NATO's galore. And of course, through it all, we kept up with school. Over the past few years, I feel like I've been waiting for the right time to simply enjoy myself, waiting for this period of senior freedom. And it's taken a while, but what I've come to realize is that I can't wait for perfect moments like these to start enjoying myself. So, I'm trying to stop spending an unreasonable amount of time tracing things to put on birthday cards, instead embracing my own needs work art style. Now I take half an hour to do my dance makeup instead of an hour of searching for symmetry. It's a work in progress. I've also enjoyed getting closer with new people in my classes this year, simply talking to you all. When we signed yearbooks last Friday, I realized just how many of you I've gotten to know better this year, which I found really heartwarming. I don't claim to have all the answers on how to live my best life, but we're moving on to new things now, and while this chapter of our novel is coming to a close, the story will continue on with new twists and characters, seemingly forever, just like the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And I'm really excited for us all, both for having made it here today and for what lies in store ahead. For many of us, we will get to start another freshman year with many more awkward icebreakers. And we will get to decide what kind of first impression we want to have. When I was little, my mom would say that there are two key components to writing speeches. The first is talking about the weather. So, what nice weather we're having today. The second, and the more important one, was thanking everyone. So I'd like to take a moment now to give a big thank you to my teachers, my parents, and my sister Nishka for helping me get to this point today. And shout out to the Juice Kids and all my friends for being on this journey with me for these past 4 years. And now to the class of 2022, thank you and congratulations. I wish you all amazingly imperfect futures. Thank you.
Congratulations. It's good to be here with you. I'm Amber Bach, Superintendent of Schools. I'm always somewhat amazed that we actually get to this day. It feels a bit miraculous to look out and think that we've conquered the week, which was full of so much. Leading up to graduation day, I typically have ideas swirling out of my head relating to a number of different topics or messages that I might want to share with you before you head off to this next important stage of your lives. This year was not quite the same for me. Perhaps it's indicative of the fatigue of these last several years, that recently I feel like I've had few words. I'm sure it's a feeling that many of you have experienced regarding the challenges of the last several years. Then this weekend, I had the opportunity to spend the holiday with my extended family, my large extended family. There are 31 of us when we are all together. We had gathered for the memorial of my mother, who had died 2 years ago, right in the midst of COVID, and for the celebration of life, the combined lives of my mother and father. My father died 8 years ago, right when I was interviewing for this job, actually, and his ashes have been waiting for my mom. Their only singular wish was to be buried together, to have their ashes commingled, and to have them put to rest together. So I actually found some words just a day or so ago when I thought about the quality of two lives exceptionally well lived. So much to say about love, acceptance, growth, change, learning to look in the same direction, blending two lives into one. Their children, the five of us, often used to say that it was really unfair to be raised in a family by two so amazingly in love people because it really raised the bar way too high for all of us in future relationships. But I don't want to actually share much with you about how amazingly in love they were, but instead about recognizing that most likely, if they had been of dating age today, in this current time, they would never have connected. My father was from the West Virginia hills of Appalachia. He didn't have indoor plumbing till he went to college, and he was the first one to be educated beyond eighth grade in his family. My mom was from a New Jersey suburb where she kept scrapbooks detailing her dating outings to parties and dances. My mom and her brother actually did performance ballroom dancing, while my father was stocking shelves at the midnight local grocery store and digging ditches for the town public works department on the weekends. They were very different people with divergent experiences and very different views about life. They had different political views, thoughts on finances, and different life experiences that often gave them opposite perspectives. Today, they might well have deleted each other on social media or swiped left on a dating app and past getting to know each other at all. Today it seems that more and more, we are expected to only be with those who are actually already just like us, who fit our social strata, our politics, our perspectives, and who opinions are perceived to be aligned. The concept of keeping friends very different from ourselves seems unlikely, if not emotionally unhealthy. Please know, I don't romanticize the time that my parents grew up in. Our lives are very different now, but to say it was entirely a simpler time would erase the nuance and the challenges of young people and what you face both now and 60 years ago. However, perhaps there is something to learn from my mom and dad's experience in comparison to today. Perhaps something is getting lost by these patterns, both mechanized and man-made, to refine our worlds to reflect our own selves. My parents' differences uniquely forged a shared family identity that resulted in an amazing life together. Our home was lively, engaged, and full of love. Our dinner table conversations were spirited, to say the least, with opposing ideas and challenges being decided by dragging newspapers, books, and old school encyclopedias to the table. Later, of course, this morphed into us just Googling it all up on our cell phones. Sometimes the sparring of ideas would get intense, but we didn't let the fear of engagement keep us from discussing things that were important or difficult. We also knew when to respect each other, back away, and then hug it out. My parents embracing the comfort and discomfort of discord shaped the lives of all their children. It shaped my capacity to live with a freshman college roommate who was incredibly different than I was. We pushed through the disagreements that brought us to the point of applying for new room assignments to become actually incredibly close friends. This same learned respect for difference and complexity has allowed me over the years to forge strong professional relationships with very different colleagues. It has grounded my own happy marriage in compromise. Across our family of 31 people, the range of perspectives continues to echo at the family dinner table, with loving arguments ending in hugs and truce, but not separation or canceling of our next gathering. Laying my parents' commingled ashes to rest, this is what I was thinking about. A wealth of different perspectives and two vastly different people joined in love. The Appalachian future doctor with the dancing Jersey girl, future artist and professional mom, both magical in their understanding of each other. So my message from them to you and from me is that I hope you'll be encouraged to lean in a bit on those discordant experiences and people who you will meet, to pause and recognize that there is something to be learned in listening to understand, and something to be earned in working to sustain a wide range of relationships. The years ahead of you have plenty of room for people and perspectives that will challenge and fascinate you. All of them can enrich you and deepen the quality of your life. My dad never could dance well enough to keep up with my mother. My mom disliked history, my dad revered it. So my dad worked on his dancing, and my mom happily tramped through every historical landmark we visited. And it was good. I wish for each of you some small portion of the love, sense of purpose, and joy that my parents had in their lives. I wish you all the best.
Good afternoon. Before I give just a few brief remarks, I would like to note that all the donors who are listed in the program have provided scholarships to the class of 2022 graduates. Their effort, their resources, and financial support provided by the donors is greatly appreciated and well deserved by our student recipients. The total amount of scholarships awarded this year totals over $135,000. Please join me in appreciating all of our donors at this time. We thank you. There is an old parable that many of you probably have heard some version of before. It's called the Triple Filter Test. Socrates was the great philosopher in ancient Greece and was held in high esteem. One day, an acquaintance of his, said, "Socrates, do you know what I just heard about your friend?" "Hold on a minute," Socrates replied. "Before telling me anything, I'd like you to pass a little test. I call it the triple filter test." "That's right," Socrates continued. "Before you talk to me about my friend, it might be a good idea to take a moment and filter what you're going to say. The first filter is truth. Have you made absolutely sure that what you were about to say to me is true?" "No," the man said. "Actually, I just heard about it, and..." "All right," said Socrates. "So you don't really know if it's true or not. Now let's try the second filter, the filter of goodness. Is what you were about to tell me about my friend something good?" "No, on the contrary," the friend said. "So," Socrates continued, "you want to tell me something bad about him, but you're not certain if it's true?" "You may still pass the test, though, because there's one filter left, the filter of usefulness. Is what you want to tell me about my friend going to be useful to me?" "No, not really." "Well," concluded Socrates, "if you want to tell me is neither true nor good nor even useful, why tell it to me at all?" Good afternoon. Looking around, all spruced up this beautiful campus is, and all the smiling faces in front of us, it's just a great feeling. Staff, administration, families, friends, and the community coming together to celebrate these 292 graduates, the 150th graduating class of Westborough High School. It's truly something special. It makes me very proud and so grateful. Seniors, you look around as well. You are so fortunate to be part of this town and all that it provides for you. There are so many fine examples throughout the town and within our WHS community of which we have come together for this great class and shared in a common experience of learning, growth, and development over the last 4 years. Please remember, seniors, all of those experiences and the moments you have gone through. They are not just great memories to share when you see each other again, but they're also because all of you have gone through so much up to now that have been critical to your growth. You've learned something about yourself and developed a character trait that you will need in the future to shape your thoughts and influence your decisions. These moments matter. The class of 2022 has risen to every challenge. Your maturity, responsibility, and extraordinary achievements at every part of this high school have genuinely provided a fabulous model for those who will follow. Thanks to each of you for how you've conducted yourself in making good on our core value of mutual respect and commitment to meaningful learning. I know you know this, but it bears repeating. Much of what you have accomplished owes so much to our talented faculty and staff, whose professional standards and commitment is by every definition truly extraordinary. They are the very soul of WHS, and we are so fortunate to have teachers and staff of such a high caliber. I hope that each member of this senior class has developed and will long embrace the values that you have learned here: mutual respect, civility, equity, social responsibility, interdependence, and a strong sense of community. These values are what defines us as Rangers. These same values are supposed to hold our vast and diverse nation and world together, too. A world that is becoming increasingly unstable. Not to mention societies in which there continues to be social unrest, political systems dysfunctional, and threats to our personal safety. Our global society desperately needs informed citizens who will protect and advance a commitment to these ideals. Our world needs a triple filter. Our world needs you. It needs you more than ever to continue to do the right things, just like you did here at Westborough High School. So go out and continue to be a Ranger. And remember, once a Ranger, always a Ranger. I offer this final piece of advice. Live a purpose-driven life. Choose to shape your own future. Resist reacting to forces beyond your control or that do not have your best interests in mind. It will take courage for sure, but it will pay off. And know that you are ready. Congratulations to every member of the great class of 2022. We will miss you, we wish you the best, and may your promising futures be healthy, happy, and truly rich with meaning. Congratulations. We are now ready to confer the diplomas.
Jillian Deborah Bolster. Elsiana Jade Aries. Zoe Tinokoyo Akpan. Gaurav Gajarel. Monique Elizabeth Allegretta. Daniel Gomes Almeida. Aishwarya Anand. Declan Gustav Anderson. Gayatri Ankalu. Jared Matthew Anton. Jonathan Zhu. Isabella Arcieri. Jadalise Alexandra Arden. Sohan Arigella. Jack Carter Armitage. Cooper James Armstrong. Dylan Hendry Arnold. Yeah! Anna Clara Augusto. Pedro Enrique Augusto. Maxwell Robert Bacon. Shinya Angus Honji. Johan Badawi. Trisha Mahesh Badranath. Christian Belairjan. Roman Connor Bajanaru. Aditi Bonsal. Kevin Suming Bao. Abigail Lee Beauregard. Benjamin Samuel Bessel. Rohan Girish Bedapur. Christelle Alam. Nahal Bardwaj. Jacob Michael Belinsky. Theo Maurice Blyer. Sophie Marie Bogart. Jackson Ryan Bond. Samuel James Boss. Nicholas Sainsbury Boyd. Sullivan Joseph Boyle. Camille Elise Bratton. Riley Benjamin Doherty. Alana Virginia Bradley. Maeve Murphy Brosnahan. Sophia Lorente Brown. Olivia Dorothy Bruno. Sophia Eleanor Bruno. Hugh Declan Burke. Grace Alexandria Burns. Sebastian Joseph Calderoni. Stephanie Barros Camargo. Colin Alexander Campbell. William Gene Campbell. Daniel Pereira Campos. Angelina Jewel Catapezza. Kellen Mason Carden. Leah Claire Casey. Richard Joseph Cautella. Aryan Muhammad Chandavarkar. Sophie Ruth Chapin. Ayush Chattopadhyay. Elizabeth Alice Cheng. Rowan Kylie Chain. Tanav Chintaputla. Ani Jane Chong. Ava Chowdhury. Peter Richard Christensen. Riley William Clark. Julie Irene Clausen. Nicholas Anthony Colella. William John Collins. Samantha Catherine Connolly. Jackson Winslow D'Elia. Nanaya Siwa Dodsey. Douglas Satoshi Dame. Malika Roseca Das. Niharika Das. Priyanka Deka. Julia Samir Demian. Rhea Dennis. Ananya Apurva Desai. Julia Jinhyang Desmond. Ronak Day. Lucas Fernando Diaz. Thomas John Didier. Nicholas Andrew DiPilato. Isabel Hannah Dreyer. Benjamin Jacob Dabrowski. Caitlin Ann Dulay. Marina George Ibrahim. Cameron Cole Eggers. Lucas Santos Feria. Kylie Marie Faulkner. Jonathan Harry Feldman. Christopher Maxwell Fernandez. Paulo Enrique Filho. Brooke Ann Fleming. Lily Pamela Fox. Lexi Jean Frittoni. Taylor Daniel Fredman. Thomas William Gagnon. Shane Elena Gallimore. Ella Shelley Gelber. Alex Kyle Goldberg. Saruyu Goripati. Hayden Christopher Goulet. Bhumika Kumar Gowda. Dharmik Kumar Gowda. Margaret Maria Graham. Skylar Rose Gravel. William Edward Gravel. Benjamin Cole Grossman. Karina Nicole Hagberg. Lindsay Mastoris Hall. Amir Harris Hamid. Callie Marie Henderson. Hunter Reese Henderson. Theo John Henderson. Emily Diane Height. Nathan Ryan Lawick. Daniel Richard Hogan. Caitlin Susan Hu. Autumn Marie Hurtado. Tabish Jawad Hussein. Utsavi Jetheth James. Anton Nigel Jayavendra. Shakoria H. Jang. Charles Roberts Johnson. Liam Ellis Johnson. Abisha Maggie Joyce. Daphne Sky Kadish. Alan Maxwell Kafig. Sonia Joyce Kang. Sai Nirmal Karunanithi. Avyukta Mandar Kelkar. Lindsay Caroline Kenny. Sydney Allison Kenny. Venya Kare. Ian Jimin Kim. Tarun Kolipara. Dhriti Komenini. Tavina Konakanchi. Emma Marie Kriz. Cassidy Rita Cronenberg. Soumya Kumar.
Colin Christopher Lake. Jackson DeForest Landroach. Ashley Nicole Langis. Aiden James Larkin. Alexis Lynn Latanzio. Caleb Keki Lawyer. Jake Matthew Leary. Sarah Rebecca Levitt. Anna Rose Levesque. Juliet Marie Levesque. Alex Jianchao Lee. Christine Shu Lee. Eric King Chow Lee. Viola Lu Lee. Autumn Sage Lieber. Selena Luo. Theodore Luo. Emma Lynn Lusick. Anisha Reddy Masharla. Bassam Majid. Samuel Armin Manuelian. Esther Mao.
Let's go!
Daniel Thomas Martin. Kyle Augusto Martins. Ella Catherine Mascherelli. Brendan Thomas McDermott. Rachel and Bernice McLaughlin. Connor Lawrence McLeod. Melissa Nicole McMillan. Riley Ann McNamara. Ashley Grace Molesky.
Enzo Mendez Lopez. Matthew Joseph Mendez. Enzo Harry Micucci. Enzo! Isabel Gunia Muhammad. Julie M. Monarchy. Celeste Moraes. Vilma Araceli Morataya Gemes. Matthew Wright Mullen. Samuel Adam Mullen. Surya Arjun Muthukumar. Mukil Nair. Divya Lakshmi Nandan. Hamza Muhammad Nasir. Shruti Nalori. Nicholas Nguyen. Molly O'Shea Northrup. Kevin Anos Nunes. Renan Vitor Nunes. Richard Dos Nunes. Jacqueline Lee O'Hare. Michael Chase Oliveri. Delfina Berenice Orellana Perez. Sophia Chantal Ormond. Ruby Ortiz. Genke Arim Padir. Kavya Pandey. Wesley Pang. Mansi Sanjay Panwar. Rhea Kayur Parikh. Kylie Elizabeth Parsons. Anthony Joseph Pascal. Rhea Dhruvkumar Patel. Caleb Jonathan Paul. Mary Therese Pelkey. Jonathan Michael Pashoda. Henry Joseph Pitterino. Alexandra Hope Popsu. Victoria Holland Pringle. Olivia Nancy Prophet. Rahul Rajesh. Paranjathi Rajkumar. Henry Johannes Ramey. Sophia Marie Rand. Olivia Catherine Rice. Charles Glenn Richards. Jake Thomas Ritaco. Alexander Jonathan Rivas Ionelli. Emily Christina Roach. Lillian Jane Roney. Anyeli Rosales. Leonardo Aldo Rivero. Sathvika Sandiri. Maida Saxena. Sophie Isabel Skirbin. Nicole Teresa Sienna Mayo. Vishisht Seku. Maria Habib Selwanes. Sarah Sherrod. Kushi Sharma. Rebecca Isabel Scher. Arshia Christopher Shishisas. Brian Alexander Silva. Matthews Gabriel Silva. Josephine Evelyn Singleton. Arman Sinha. Kyle Brendan Skinner. Ella Brianna Sklar. Harrison Paul Smith. Charles Donald Snow. Sarah Elaine Steck. Adam Lewis Steinberg. Duncan Robert Stevens. Eamon Gerard Stevens. Nishit Sagar Sura. Amshreya Swain. Umar Ali Syed Quadri. Sean Tam. Abby Marie Thompson. McKenna Lynn Thrush. Griffin Farrell Townsend. Jeremias Ruben Usmejia. Shreya Vaidyanathan. Kylie Mackenzie Valley. Evan Vasilios Vasilakis. Roxanne Christina Venditti. Brady Joseph Volan. Adam Matthew Von Maszewski. Vainavi Naga Srikumara Vupu. Emerson Evelyn Waite. Anzu Wang. Kaylin Carr Washington. Andrew Benjamin Weiner. and James Welch. Colin Kenneth West. Eli Michael Westford. Bella Wiggum. Kristen Lee Willikowski. Matthew Francis Willer. Tyler Mark Wilson. Selena Jinhui Xiong. Sophie Zhu. Daniel Zhu Zhang. Tiffany Zhang. Zinrui Zhu. Arushi Panth. Isabel Ruchen Gu. Melissa Mingyi Kwong. Edward Henwul Chang. Andrew Zhu Chen. Sasha Samantha Wilkinson.
One more loud and honorable congratulations to the class of 2022. Close out the ceremony, I would ask class president Sasha Wilkinson to come forward and lead our graduates to the conclusion of this ceremony. Sasha?
Hi. So we're going to do the turning of the tassels. Would the class of 2022 graduates please stand? On the count of three, two, one.
Thank you.